Tonight's show is dedicated to very short Native Americans.
That's a joke. I'm kidding. Is that, it's not. You know, I know you probably think, what? No, it was me holding a feather because, because I've used up all the puppets. And it's very hot here in Los Angeles. Very, very hot. And all the puppets died. I'm glad you find that so funny. You say people in LA are heartless. There's your proof, ladies and gentlemen of America. I said the puppets had died and they laughed. No, the puppets didn't die. They're fine. They're actually in an air-conditioned unit heading to their beach home. But they've left me this. Do you know, I wish more people wore feathers. I would quite like to. Ladies used to wear feathers in their hair, didn't they? And then you can do that dance where you show off different parts of your body, like that. I mean, this feather would be fine up there, but I'd need a huge feather hair. I don't wish to blow my own trumpet, but. But I could if I wanted to. Anyway, what I'm saying is, this, you know, they used to be the fan dancers, and they would dance like that with, they call them fan dancers, but they used feathers. And they would do that. That's what's missing nowadays.
Gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Hey! Who the hell are you? Come on in. Welcome to Los Angeles, California. Welcome to the Late Late Show. I am your host, TV's Craig Ferguson. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Yes. All right, that's enough now. That's enough. Please. I know I'm from another country, but I'm not in the Beatles. What the hell does that even mean? Man, there's a lot of ladies in the audience tonight. Wow. And at home, too, I see. You look nice. Had your hair done? Lost a few pounds, got new shoes? You too, ladies. You look good, too. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's hot, though. It's hot. It's hot in California. It's very hot here in California. How hot is it, Craig? I don't know. It's not a proper late night show. I don't have jokes about how hot it is. It's just hot. How hot is it? It's hot. There you are. It's hot. It is hot. Also, the fires are raging. I don't know if you can see. The fires are raging out in Southern California. Miss California immediately put out a statement saying she's okay with flaming things just as long as they don't get married. So we're good. Also in California, Manny Ramirez of the LA Dodgers tested positive for a steroid that's sometimes used as a sexual enhancer. Apparently, Manny couldn't get to third base on his own, so he needed some kind of some kind of thing. You know, you're really mad about me doing the hot thing, aren't you? Anyway, I there was a new show premiered on Bravo earlier tonight. I watched it because, of course, this show is live. It's called The Fashion Show. It's about this show. It's about a group of fashion designers who compete against each other to win a grand prize. What an amazing idea. What would a show like that be like? It would kind of be exactly like Project Runway. It's exactly like Project Runway. Actually, I have no problem with similarities between two shows. I'm a big fan of Project Runway, but it's okay to have two fashion contest shows. You can have a wife swap and trading spouses. You can have The View and When Animals Attack. You can have two shows of that niche. Anyway, this new show is going to be a little different from Project Runway because it has Isaac Mizrahi instead of Tim Gunn. Do we have a picture of Isaac Mizrahi? There he is. That's back when he was in the Crips or something. I don't know. I like Isaac Mizrahi. He's a very, very talented man. He can make an outfit out of anything. And in today's USA Today, he made a sexy dress out of old newspapers. I've done that. I have. One of USA Today's pie charts rubbed off on my ass. Why does pie always go straight to my ass? I have no idea. Anyway, Isaac Mizrahi comes from a long line of eccentric fashion designers, and I like them. My favourite is Karl Lagerfeld. Do we have a picture of Karl Lagerfeld? There he is. Look at that. That's your fashion designer right there. Look at that guy. You don't look at that guy and you go, well, what does he do? Is he an engine driver or something? Look at this guy. Hey, what do you do, buddy? You work in construction? No, that is a fashion designer, that guy. I love the way he dresses like the captain of a gay vampire cruise. That's the way you should look. I know he's got the...
We're sailing to Transylvania. Who's for bingo?
I made myself laugh there. That's good. Anyway... Karl Lagerfeld used to be the designer at a fashion house called Chloe in Paris, and his position was taken over by Stella McCartney. And she's a very successful fashion designer now, and her dad, of course, is Paul McCartney. And Paul is delighted for his daughter's success. Do we have a picture of Paul, how happy he is about it? There he is. It's Paul.
Good old reliable show.
Anyway, Stella McCartney even has her own string of retail stores, which are terrific, a great look. Do we have a picture of Stella McCartney? Stop it! That's a picture of a young Angela Lansbury. A picture of Stella McCartney. There you are. I don't even know who that is. That was Stella McCartney. Anyway, I'm talking about this new show, The Fashion Show. I'll probably watch it, because I watch Project Runway and I like it. But the only trouble is fashion nowadays, it's kind of boring. You know, I wish would come back? Cod pieces. Cod pieces and shoulder pads. And only, and nothing else, just a cod piece and shoulder pads. I'd come out here with just a cod piece and shoulder pads, I'd be like, mm-hmm. Do you like that? What? You like that walk that models do? That model's got attitude and they come out going like this. I thought attitude was maybe about perspective or your point of view or something. No, apparently it's about this. It's not attitude, that's restless leg syndrome. Anyway, people think LA is a very fashion conscious town, but it's not. It's not at all. All you see in LA are people dressed like they're going to go to the gym, but they don't go. They dress like they're going to work out during the day, then at night, all the ladies dress up as prostitutes. It's one of the reasons why I love living here. Do you know what city has interesting fashion? Las Vegas. Very sequiny in Las Vegas. They've got a look all of their own. Right now, Cher has a show at Caesar's Palace in Vegas, and it's very glittery and sparkly, but she looks great. Do we have a picture of Cher? There she is. She's gone. Vegas, they've got this shopping mall. It's called the Fashion Mall. And what happens is that the runway comes out of the ground and the models are all walking up and down, right? And right there in the mall. And right next to it, they've got a huge food court. And sometimes the models go into the food court and then they come out, they go across to the vomit lounge. It's embarrassing, though, if you're eating in the food court, you're just walking down eating, and then suddenly the runway comes up. You have to do your walking like that with your salmon. Now, a lot of celebrities have their own fashion lines. Johnny Carson used to have his own line of suits. I tried to launch my own fashion line. Apparently, no one wanted Craig Ferguson's assless casuals. By the way, the assless casuals was the name of a violent soccer gang I used to belong to, the assless casuals. You're welcome, people who are on the YouTube in Britain. That's a good joke if you're in Britain. It's... doesn't really work here. All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the big show where I cussed earlier on, but I won't be cussing again. So you can wake the kids up and bring them through. Everything's going to be fine. Wake up, children. The Scottish Conan guy promised not to swear anymore. Oh, happy day, Father. Now we can watch TV without being corrupted. I don't know why Dickensian people are watching television, but they are, apparently. The characters from A Christmas Carol. Here, Mr. Scrooge, do you mind if I watch a bit of television? I do, Bob Cratchit, because television hasn't been invented yet. What you're talking about is fanciful, Cratchit. It's fanciful. You know, some nights I'm the only one that enjoys this show, and I don't care. I know. Let's see what we got here. Do we have time for emails? Yes, we do. This is from Josh in Palo Alto in California. Oh, you can tell because it's all hot and limp and everything. Hot, limp, remind you of anyone? Josh says, Dear Craig, if Star Trek is supposedly in the future, why is there only one Asian man? Don't you think there would be more than that in the future? Not touching it. Not touching it. No, no, no. No, not going anywhere near that. This is from Kenny in Idaho Springs, which is in Colorado. What the? Kenny says, Dear Craig, if you were Miss USA, what would be the first thing you would do as Miss USA? Wow. As for my grand finale, once I had taken the crown, I would walk out to the judges and show them my penis. Right there, I'd say. And I'd say, I would walk out with a crown. I'd walk out with a crown. I'd whip off my pants and I'd say, ha-ha! Gotcha! And then I would accept millions of dollars as the spokesmodel for Nair. I did that once. You know they make Nair for men? They do. They make Nair for men. This guy, you're quite a hairy guy. You probably know a bit about it, yeah. They make, and they've got, it's all like... Like on the tube of Nair or what, the can or this canister, it's like Nair for men, you know, to try and make it tough to take it. Oh, funny. The idea of taking hair off is somehow manly. Ah, I feel like I'm back when men were shaved. And anyway. So I get this, some of this stuff, and I put it in my, I'm not a very hairy man. I'm not like you. You're part, you know, partially gorilla, really. So I put some of this on. I've got a little bit of hair there, and I put it on, and I wait the required 3 minutes. I rub it off. The hair comes off like it was never there, never at all. Best damn night of my life. This is from Kelsey in Wichita Falls in Texas. Wichita Falls is a lovely name for a town, isn't it? It's almost like the opening number of a musical. Welcome to Wichita Falls. And everybody all comes out. Welcome to Wichita Falls. We're your folks right here. Welcome to Wichita Falls, where we nair our chests all day. We nair our chests and we live right here and we watch TV all night. Anyway, well, no, please, please. Kelsey said... Kelsey says, Dear Craig, who would you trust more? Someone who says they always tell the truth or someone who says they will always tell lies? That's just stupid. This is from Colin in Cowan in West Virginia. Cowan. Dear. Sometimes I think of really dirty jokes and I don't say them, and that's awesome. Not really. The CBS is very grateful for that. They should be for the one I thought of here. Anyway, anyway, Colin says, Dear Craig, why are nude beaches popular in Europe, yet they barely exist in America? Well, that's because America has a great history. The country that I love, I'm an American by choice, but we have a great history of unreasonable Puritanism here. And this comes from our, you know, our history. We were, you know, a country founded by the Puritans, people who had to escape England in the Middle Ages because the religious practices weren't strict enough. In England in the Middle Ages. It wasn't conservative enough for them. I don't know, actually. There should be more nude... It'd be good to have nude beaches. Are there nude beaches in California? Yes. That's a rhetorical question. It's funny that the only time you get any reaction at the audience when you ask talk about nude beaches, the rest of the time, they're like, oh, please, when's Matthew on, for heaven's sake? he'll be on in a minute, don't you worry. Actually, he'll be on after the break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the big hot show, the hot show in LA, where it's very hot today. How hot is it, Craig? I'd rather not say. Suffice to say, it's hot. I'm very sorry about earlier on, you know, when I said that word that you'll never hear. Not till I'm on cable. Then you'll hear it all the time. Anyway, my first guest tonight, big giant movie star. He stars, his new movie is called Ghosts of Girlfriends Past. It's in theaters now. Take a look at this.
I'm flattered, really. I'm not toasting anyone tomorrow, okay? I can't toast this.
You know what? Let's talk about something else. When do you catch your flight?
Well, Ollie, you know where I come out on all this, buddy? To me, marriage is an archaic and oppressive institution that should have been abolished years ago. All right, and love? All right, it's magical comfort food for the weak and the uneducated. Yeah, it makes you feel all warm and relevant, but in the end, love leaves you weak, dependent, and fat.
What? I think someone's afraid of intimacy. Please welcome Matthew McConaughey, everybody.
Hey, Greg?
I'm good, buddy. How are you?
Pretty damn nice.
Yeah, man. Yeah, you're good. Yeah. Have a nice... Enjoy your beverage here. I'll just join you.
Rattlesnake tour.
Yeah, you get that one and I get this one.
Mine's loaded.
Yeah, you're Mine's in my loaded. Airstream now, buddy.
This is the welcome card.
Yeah, I give you a welcome card with Airstream on it.
A little 15-footer on the cover.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Is that like yours? You very famously have one of those, don't you?
I got a 28-footer. I got a...
Airstream we're talking?
Yeah.
Right.
I got a 34-footer. And then I got a 25-footer, 1952.
Good Lord, you have three?
Three.
Yeah. No wonder you never put your shirt on, sir. How are you? Are you good?
I'm good, man. Family's good. Work's good. Health's good.
You've
Mama's
got
good.
Your kid must be
10 months.
10 months
today.
Oh, congratulations!
Thank
That's
you,
lovely.
Man.
Yeah. Thank you. 10 months. What's going on? You getting any sleep?
I am, because he's got a good mama.
Ah, right.
Yeah. I'm getting sleep. I'm getting my 8 hours, man. What's happening now? He's going to swimming classes.
He won't be walking yet. Is he walking yet?
Pretty damn close.
Yeah, really?
Yeah,
10 months?
Yeah.
That's early.
He skipped.
You got yourself a walker there, man.
We do have a walk.
He'll be. You don't want. It's not good when they
That's
start walking.
That's what everybody says.
Oh, man. It goes DEFCON 3 to DEFCON 1 when they start. Oh, they're
you
all over
play
the place.
Goalie, right?
Well, they do for the next... Well, they start learning to walk, and then for the next 2 years, everywhere they can find an outlet for electricity, they're there with their little fingers.
That's starting to happen, and everyone's telling us, no, you don't want to rush him to walk. So his mother, myself, and his grandmother, like, got him on those... You know those two ties where they're on, like, a little vest, and you hold them up above
Walk around. I have one of those, but not for walking. Yeah.
It goes with the feather, right?
Yeah, it goes with the feather. Yeah, that's right.
And the cod piece.
Yeah, the cod piece, the shoulder pads. You've seen my act! You've seen my act!
So Levi's running around in that same outfit this morning. Anyway, he's doing the. We got a big canyon out, and it's about 50 feet down and 50 feet up, and he's walking. And everybody keeps coming by, going, "Better slow down on the teaching him to walk." For that reason, because once he does it, you're playing goalie.
Yeah, the whole
rest
time.
Of the rest of
the
your
whole
life,
time. So. Yeah, no, it's crazy. It's zone defense.
You
after
got an 8 year old?
Huh?
8 year old?
Yeah, I'm trying to keep him from walking.
Oversized.
Sit down. You sit down.
Oversized codpiece. Just
I get him to wear the shoulder pads and the codpiece just like his daddy. No, it's good. Now, listen, do you drive your Airstream around? Do you drive around, you know? Well, do you just pull it behind you? Man, you must be made of steel.
I've got to keep getting bigger trucks to pull this thing because the one I've got now... It all matters kind of weight. Like this one, a 15-footer, you could pull that with any car. You could pull that with a Camry. Right. Right? Whatever you wanted to.
Wait a minute, hang on. Who advertises on CBS? Ford, isn't it? You could probably pull that with a Ford. Couldn't you? Yeah.
Actually, you know, coming to the next one, the 28-footer, I pull that with a Ford F-250 diesel.
Really? The F-250? I have the F-350.
Oh.
I do.
Check this out.
Yeah.
The 34-footer, though, which is going to weigh 16,500 pounds, I'm going to have to go to the F-450.
That's a very heavy trailer.
That's a lot of weight.
16,000, because my airplane only weighs 3,500 pounds.
You know? It's true, though.
Yeah.
Because I was just in Acapulco, and I forgot about coming on the show, so I had to hop on my G5 to show up.
All right. Game set,
you pull them all over.
Are you go, do you go on road trips with them? Are you going anywhere exciting? I love the idea of doing this, by the way. This to me is Americana.
It's
right
a great
there.
Way to see it, man.
Yeah.
It's a great way to see the country. I mean, you can fly, we travel. You fly into places, you stay in a hotel, you go to work. You don't really see the place.
No, not at all.
But you get on the road and you know, it's a slower amount of time. You get to see the country. And America, man, I mean, I've been across it many times. I've been to 47 of the states.
I think, me too, actually, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think.
And still...
I have. No, seriously, I have. I have. No, yeah. I don't know what the hell they're laughing at. I really have.
He just gets his citizenship, and he's been around all
over. No, I've lived here for a long time. I've been all over. I used to go on my motorcycle, and then I got a little too kind of scared.
Yeah.
And so now I go in a big car. A Ford, actually.
Yeah.
An F-350. Yeah, no, I go all around.
What's your favorite area in the States?
I like going to the South, actually. I have a very nice time in the South, because it was surprising to me. Well, you're from Texas.
Yeah.
It's not, that's kind of like a separate area on its own.
It's
but
its own the country.
But the oh yeah, because Rick Perry was saying, you know.
Oh yeah, yeah. Sovereignty.
Yeah. What do you think? Yeah. Are you, would you be happy to secede from the Union?
It's a mighty big question.
Yeah, I guess. It's a little too big. But the South I like to go to because I went to Arkansas, a town called Ozark in Arkansas, and I tasted catfish. You ever had catfish?
Oh yeah.
That's an ugly fish.
But it tastes good.
It tastes fantastic.
Tastes great.
Yeah, yeah, but you wouldn't want to look at it before you eat it. You want to eat it and then get that kind of information.
They're bottom feeders, you know, but they taste good.
Much like this show, actually.
But they taste great.
When I've been to Texas, in Austin in particular, they have a lot of hot sauces.
In Austin.
Did you really?
Yeah, University of Texas.
That's a great city, Austin. Isn't
it? Yeah, it is cool.
It's very, and they have the hot sauces. You ever go to that hot sauce store there? Got all the different hot sauces. Very hot.
Yeah.
As hot as California today. If you know what I'm saying.
Today.
Yeah, it's very hot. How hot is it today in California, Matthew?
I'd say it's feeling like low 90s.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, yeah. With a low pressure area moving in from the.
Not as hot as it gets in Texas, though.
No, it gets very hot in Texas. Yeah.
No, I haven't been to that hot sauce tour you're talking about, but I love the hot sauces, and I got all kinds of hot sauces.
Do you make them?
Yeah.
Really?
Mix them up, yeah.
What do you use?
Usually it's a mix of different sauces, and then I'll go to the grocery store and get a whole bunch of different peppers from the pepper section, put them in a blender. I got a really badass blender.
Really?
Yeah.
What kind of a blender do you have?
I can't even say the name of it. It's so badass.
Oh, really?
It's a Pro Series. They use it on Top Chef.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. They use mine on Iron Chef.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
They're using mine now on Iron Chef America.
Oh, yeah? They use mine in the CIA.
Oh, yeah? Mine's coming out unreleased version, Signature Series, by myself in the next Mission Impossible.
That's pretty good. Yeah. Can I ask you? We're out of time. Can I ask you what this is? This is
a guy, Mishka. This is a guy who's with my record company, Just Keep Living Records, and I was co-producer on this album. It's a great reggae album that we made. It's
I like
out.
A bit of reggae.
Yeah, check this out. It's not a bastard.
Hey.
That but was, it's a great album. And
well,
real
this fella here doesn't look that reggae-ish to me, if you know what I'm saying.
Well, when you hear him, you won't think that he's white. But he makes beautiful music, Ken.
Yeah, I want to give you one of those. That's what it's all about. Absolutely.
I want to give you one of those.
Thanks. This is very new technology for CBS. This is what the folks are calling the CD.
That's the CD,
right? CD right here. Mishka. Mishka.
Yeah,
what's it called? Above the Bones? I listen to this. I do like a bit of reggae. Could we have this fellow on the show? Could we? We could. Could we?
We'd
would
love
you mind?
Have him on the show. Love to.
Yeah, we'll have him on the show. That would be nice.
Bam.
Yeah.
Great.
And when he comes on the show, maybe as some kind of Piola, you could get me one of them blenders, Matthew.
Crazy
good to meet you,
that,
sir.
Man.
Matthew McConaughey, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Hot Show, a show that got pretty hot when Matthew McConaughey was here. I was thinking, if it just got a little bit hotter, he might have taken his shirt off. But he didn't. He's very nice, though. I liked him. Wasn't he nice? What a nice man. I like Texans, though. I got to be honest with you. I've always had a nice time with Texans. Not necessarily men Texans, but they... But not necessarily not. I don't know. You don't know me. Anyway, my next guest is an award-winning journalist. Our best-selling book, We Are Our Mother's Daughters, is in stores now. Please welcome Cokie Roberts, everybody. Cokie. Hello, Cokie. I'm good. How are you doing?
All right, but I have a really lame blender.
A lame blender?
What's wrong? My blender doesn't do any of the things that your blender
does.
Oh,
the blender? I thought you said blunder. I thought, I thought lame blunder? You've come to the right place. I'm the king of the lame blunder. No. Hey, listen, this, very nice. I think you look even nicer here. You look lovely this evening, and that's not the same blouse, is it?
No, it's not. But I bought it. I actually did buy it in the same airport.
You buy your clothes in airports?
I do.
Are you not a very fashion-conscious person? Because you look very fashionable.
No, no,
you look,
you
look, you got the three buttons there, which mean success, liberty, and
something
else.
We won't say.
Let's not.
Till you get the cable show.
Oh, yeah. You know something I don't know?
No.
Is Washington a very fashion-conscious town?
No, not really. No, we're notoriously dowdy.
Yeah.
In fact, I have a story of one time a New York fashion person actually came to town, and he said to me, I never get it right here. I was at the White House the other night, and I went up to a woman, and I said to her, that's a fabulous suit. Is it Ralph Lauren? And she said, I'm a Marine.
Oh, my God. Well, the only answer to that is, I know, but is that Ralph Lauren? What about the Obamas, though? They're very fashionable,
very
aren't
fashionable,
they?
Yes.
Michelle Obama, she's got the sleeveless dresses.
And the
dresses.
Arms, right. Yeah, very nice. Doing them.
That caused a huge furore when she wore the...
Yes, but then we found out Jackie did it, so it was all okay.
All right, yeah. Yeah. Do you think that'll change Washington? It'll become...
We'll all start going sleeveless?
No. Because some of these people would look more like Larry the Cable Guy than Michelle Obama.
That's what I would advise against it.
I don't want to see Cheney in anything sleeveless. Or do I?
No.
Hey, are you going to the White House Correspondents another show?
No, don't have to.
You didn't go when I did it either. What's wrong?
Because I hate it.
Yeah.
It's Saturday night. Uh-huh. You could always be doing something better, like watching reruns of your show or something.
On Saturdays?
I don't know. Do they run?
I don't know. I'm always doing something better. Blending things. Yeah. Taking my trailer up and down.
Lots of interesting things. Yeah. In 47 states.
I've been to quite a lot of the states in America. How many have you been to?
I think I've been to 49.
What one have you not been to?
North Dakota.
I've been to North Dakota.
What were you doing there?
I actually was in Canada and I needed a break. It's true. It's true. What part of America are you from?
I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana.
Oh, wow, that's a great place. Yeah. Do you still go back there a lot?
I go all the time.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you have a house there?
My mother has a home on Bourbon Street.
Whoa!
I mean right smack dab in the middle of all the honky-tonk on Bourbon Street.
Wow, that's fantastic.
When my children were small, we'd walk past the strippers and the other neighbors, and I'd say through the woods and over the hills to grandmother's house.
That's fantastic. And tell me, is your mother a problem drinker?
No.
Okay,
my mother does.
Because that's where you want to live if you're a problem drinker, is right there. Yeah. Because it becomes much less of a problem. Right?
No problem.
It's a big party. Do you enjoy the jazz music
then? Of course.
Really?
It's wonderful. New Orleans is a wonderful place. The food is wonderful. Mm. The music's wonderful. My mother's 93 and going strong.
Is she a jazz aficionado?
She knows it all. My mother was a member of Congress for many years, and then she was the United States ambassador to the Vatican.
No.
Yes.
What pope was it?
John Paul.
All right.
And so I teased her that, you know, she moved from Bourbon Street to the Vatican, and... the costumes didn't change.
Hey, now. Hey. You make a point.
Guys in dresses, yeah.
Have you ever been to the Vatican?
Yes.
It's fascinating, isn't it?
Yes,
I was amazed when I went there. It's huge.
Yeah. And the paintings are quite spectacular.
Yeah? Hmm? What paintings do you like?
And then but you do kind of, as you're marching through and looking at all of that, you kind of get Martin Luther.
You mean Reformation type things? There's a lot of people here think Martin Luther is Martin Luther King.
Oh, okay.
You know, because
I mean, that's what they're thinking.
Martin Luther, of course.
1500,
Was he German, Martin Luther, or Swiss?
He was German. He knocked up the, you know.
He didn't knock up anyone. Martin Luther didn't knock up anybody. He put his theses on the door of the cathedral,
right.
And he started the Protestant movement.
And I'm a good Catholic girl, but when you're at the Vatican and see all of that around you,
Do you know why he did that, Martin Luther?
Because he didn't like indulgences.
Indulgences, papal indulgences. Yeah, it was what they were selling entry to heaven, basically. It was a bit like Washington lobbyists
Very
today,
much so.
Really, in many ways.
Well, I've always thought that. I mean, that's the whole business about praying to saints. You're asking the saint to intercede. What is that? Lobbying.
I guess. Yeah. Although I think we're probably getting into a lot of trouble now with this conversation. So just to be safe, I'll disagree very strongly with you there, Cokie. How dare you?
The book. The book says we are our mother's daughters.
What does that mean, we are our mother's daughters? Because clearly I'm not.
No.
Is it a book only for ladies?
No. Men are actually allowed to read it.
Right.
It's about women in all kinds of roles in American society, politicians and soldiers and athletes and scientists and all of that. But it is also personal roles. But what I do get is this very funny reaction of women saying, we are our mother's daughters. You know, I don't think so. You can't make me be my mother's daughter.
We definitely are. You are. But, I mean, I've got two sisters, and they are definitely my mother's daughters. No doubt in my mind at all, actually, about that.
Did your mother have any sons?
My mother had two sons, me and my brother.
It was a trick question.
Was it?
No. Oh, yeah!
No, you know what happened? No, I've either been drinking something out of this snake mug or I got a contact high from Matthew. One of the two, I'm definitely...
Well, that's understandable.
Yeah. But this is about feminism, are you finished with it now, or will there be more?
Women's rights.
Yeah. Is it all equal now? Are we done?
Do you know what the percentage of white men is in this country? Take a guess.
12?
There are more of you than that, but not a whole lot more.
Really? What is the percentage?
36%.
Really?
And you know, yeah. In the last election, of course, we all called up the Census Bureau and said, when did white men stop being the majority?
Right.
And they said they never were.
Wow.
Just always acted like it.
Yeah. I don't want to, you know, get controversial here, but
no,
our president is not a white man.
No.
You know.
Hey,
I don't know if that's news to anybody. I mean, that's good, isn't it?
That is good.
That's a step in the right direction,
absolutely
surely.
Absolutely a step in the right direction. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, there we are.
But, you know, the whole election night, which was an exciting night. It was an exciting night and historic and all that. And everybody kept saying, it shows that a child in America can grow up to be anything he wants to be.
Mm-hmm.
And I kept thinking, unless he is a she.
I don't know. Hillary got pretty damn close, don't you think?
Close. It's,
what?
It's no cigar.
Yeah, no, actually. That's a very poor turn of phrase there, if you don't mind me saying so. We're completely out of time, Cokie. Cokie Roberts, everybody. We'll be right back.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
Well, what did we learn on the show? I tell you what I learned. I learned that Matthew McConaughey has a fabulous blender. Wonder if he just blends in the middle of the night. Wonder if he just gets up when it's hot, you know, and thinks, oh, I've got to go and blend something. He's got a pair of shorts on or something. Just goes up, goes to the blender. Blend something. I am very worried about me. But not so much, really. So we learned about that. And then we learned that Cokie Roberts doesn't care if I get fired for her religious views. Good night, everybody.